Game streaming on a single computer comes with some inherent issues and struggles with performance and workflow. As hardware improves more and more, some of the primary low-hanging fruit performance concerns have become less of an issue. A Ryzen 3950X or 5950X are more than good enough to game and stream with virtually any settings you'd realistically be able to stream with on a single PC setup. And GPU encoding, at least over on Team Green, is more than good enough for the vast majority of creators out there. But there are other reasons you might feel compelled to set up a secondary streaming PC. One such reason has been issues hooking certain games, be it games that block the hook outright like Counter-Strike Go or Destiny 2, or games which do not cooperate well with game hooks such as Warzone. Let's talk about this. I'm EposVox, your stream professor, and the beta for OBS version 27, the new update, has just released, and it includes a fix for an issue that has kept me on dual PC streaming for most of my PC gaming streams, despite the fact that I have absurdly powerful hardware at my disposal. OBS version 27 includes updates and fixes for the game capture hook for DirectX 12 games. DX 12 games have been notoriously frustrating to deal with as a streamer, none more so than Call of Duty Warzone. The specific scenario that has pushed me back to dual PC streaming when I was still living at my apartment was Warzone and capturing frames with either a massive stutter or even sending frames to OBS completely out of order, despite the fact that OBS wasn't reporting any issues. This absolutely plagued my streams, despite the fact that the core render or encode performance of OBS had zero reported issues. It was simply the DirectX hook itself causing the issue. It didn't matter that I had a Threadripper 3000 CPU, an i9-9900K, or an RTX 2080, or RTX Titan, raw performance wasn't the concern. The hook just would not cooperate. Switching to dual PC and using a capture card to hook the video data over HDMI instead of through software was my only fix at the time. This and other hooking issues have been widespread with Warzone and with some other DirectX 12 titles, and OBS 27 comes with the fix for DirectX 12 game capture hooks that should alleviate this issue for most users. Huzzah! Some people were even using capture cards within their single PC streaming setups to alleviate this, which should be less necessary now as well. There's a second fix which can be helpful here too. I do want to point out though that this fix doesn't do anything for games that actually block the hook outright, just improving performance for games which you could already hook. The second fix I'm referring to adds a new capture method for display capture called Windows Graphics Capture, or WGC. This was previously added as a window capture source a couple updates ago, which helped with capturing Vulkan games and UWP games, and it's now available for display capture as well. This method should have less performance issues or hitching than was experienced with the old DXGI or DirectX graphics infrastructure method of capturing your desktop. This can help smooth things over when you need to use display capture instead of game capture sources. Even better, this new method seems to be more stable when your graphics driver hiccups a bit, and it seems to have a lot better time capturing displays hooked up to secondary GPUs, which the old display capture method generally could not do. This means that laptops with both an iGPU and a dedicated GPU, as well as some dual PC desktop systems, will have less black screen issues now. I still haven't seen substantial evidence or have been able to recreate a scenario where dual GPUs for streaming is a good idea on desktop, nevertheless helps anything in the first place. But for those who insist on doing it anyway, this will make your life easier. Is dual PC streaming dead? No. No, it's not. If performance was your only real concern, dual PC could have been dead for you for a couple years now, but single PC streaming will still struggle to be viable once you start introducing multicam configurations, introducing a ton of media sources, management of some other tools, things like that. But these latest OBS updates will certainly make lives a lot easier for those who want to stick with single PC streaming. Both are completely valuable options and, you know, realistic choices, and I'm stoked to see OBS making things better along the way. You know what else I'm stoked for? New creators getting into streaming or YouTube to find a career path or build an audience. For that, I recommend checking out Marquez Brownlee's latest Skillshare course on YouTube success. Skillshare is our sponsor for today's video and is an online learning community for creatives where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey. Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring courses for creative and curious people on topics such as graphics design, photography, freelancing, music production, and of course, video production, like the course I'm recommending. They even have classes from some familiar faces, such as the new course from MKBHD that I just recommended, it should be at the top of your list. Skillshare is for real working creatives and lifelong learners who are never content being stuck where they're at and always want to improve. That sounds like a lot of my viewers. It's curated specifically for learning, so there's no ads and there's always new premium courses being launched like MKBHD's. For less than $10 per month with an annual subscription, it's a fantastic deal. But if somehow that's not good enough for you, the first 1,000 people to sign up with my link in the description will get a free trial of Skillshare Premium. Happy learning. This is just one of a few videos I have coming out for the new OBS version, so get subscribed for more. The beta just released at the time of recording, so there's a lot of cool stuff to dive into and test before it's even fully released, but there is some neat stuff I want to tell you about. If you have any questions about the update, sound off in the comments below or join us on Discord, discord.gg/EposVox. I'm EposVox, your stream professor. I'll see you next time.